probability, permutations. This is a Leaving Cert higher level maths question. In part one, we want to know how many different ways could we arrange 6 books on a shelf. Let's imagine these are the books, these placeholders here. So I'm going to create these little cards, if you wish, for the 6 books. Now let's think, how many options would we have for the first position? Well, we have 6 books. So in the first place, there's 6 choices. In the second, only 5, because we've used up one of the books. Then 4, 3, 2, and 1. So these are the options. And by the fundamental principle of counting, if we multiply these options, we get the total number of possibilities. 6 by 5 by 4 by 3 by 2 by 1 is called 6 factorial. We can use the calculator to find this quickly. So there's a button with an exclamation mark here on the calculator, the factorial button. So 6, shift, and the factorial button will give us the answer 720. We could multiply it out the long way either. We could also use permutations that 6p6 on the calculator would give you the same answer. In the second question, there's a restriction in place. So this time we're told that the science book has to be on the extreme left. So let's again create our 6 positions. So we have 6 cards out here. And let's think about the options we have for each. So in the first position, we're told the science book has to be here. So we only have one option. We have one choice. Now there are 5 books left to choose from the next. And then 4, 3, 2, and 1. So the answer to this question, when we multiply our options, would be 1 by 5 factorial, which is 5 factorial. So again, taking out the calculator, we'll evaluate 5 factorial. And we see the answer is 120. If you write in your calculator 5p5, you see you get the same answer.